got back into their country to tell the story, the colony was undone, so that letting them know that they would not have any mercy, they fell to work with their canoes and destroyed every one that the storm had not destroyed before, at the sight of which the savages raised a hideous cry in the woods, which our people heard plain enough, after which they ran about the island like distracted men, so that in a word, our men did not really know what at first to do with them. Nor did the Spaniards, with all their prudence, consider that while they made those people thus desperate, they ought to have kept a good guard at the same time upon their plantations. For though it is true they had driven away their cattle, and the Indians did not find out their main retreat, I mean my old castle at the hill, nor the cave in the valley, yet they found out my plantation at the bower, and pulled it all to pieces, and all the fences, and planting about it, trod all the corn underfoot, tore up the vines and grapes, being just then almost ripe, and did our men inestimable damage, though to themselves not one farthing's worth of service. Though our men were able to fight upon them all occasions, yet they were in no condition to pursue them or hunt them up and down, for as they were too nimble of foot for our people when they found them single, so our men durst not go abroad single, for fear of being surrounded with their numbers. The best was, they had no weapons, for though they had bows, they had no arrows left, nor any materials to make any, nor had they any edge tool among them. The extremity and distress they were reduced to was great, and indeed deplorable, but at the same time our men were also brought to very bad circumstances by them,